In a previous movie, we created shaders for the pickguard, various metal parts, head, and neck of this guitar. In this movie, you'll learn how to create a custom shader for the body. We want to create a really dazzling body for this guitar that will shine on stage. The look we're going to aim for is a bold base color with glittering flakes embedded in the paint. Unfortunately, unlike the previous movie, there is no substance that fits our need in this case, so we're going to have to create our own custom shader network. In the Hypershade, open the Surface Shader list and create a new layered shader. A layered shader will allow us to layer multiple shaders on top of each other. Rename the shader to Body Matte. We'll return to the shader in a bit. Create a new Lambert material and name it to Body Diffuse Matte. When creating layered shaders, it's common practice to split up the diffuse layer, representing the base color, and the specular layer, representing the shininess. We're going to drive the diffuse color of this using a ramp. A ramp will create a gradient that is richer than a flat color. Click the Map button next to the color and select Ramp. Let's make our guitar a stunning red. Click the middle handle and then click Selected Color. Change the color to a deep red. This is our base color. Now we want to create a gradient going from a much darker red to a much lighter red. So select the top and bottom handles and change the colors appropriately. Finally, click anywhere on the ramp to create one more handle and give it your base color. Drag the two middle handles out so that the majority of the ramp matches the base. Now let's add this layer to the main body material. Select Body Matte in the Hypershade so that it appears in the Attribute Editor, and middle mouse drag the Body Diffuse Matte tile into the Layers section, outlined in red. Delete the green default layer by clicking the small X below it. Now your layered shader has its diffuse layer. Apply this shader to the guitar body and try rendering the scene using the Render Frame button. You can see the gradient, but it's not in the direction we were expecting. It seems to move from light to dark across the body. But in real life, the gradient should move from light to dark as it heads away from the person looking at it. This is known as the Fresnel effect. We can fix this by making use of the direction the camera is facing. In the Hypershade, go to the Utilities list and create a Sampler Info node. The Sampler Info node samples information from each point on the guitar's surface as it is being rendered. Now middle drag the Sampler Info node onto the Ramp node and select Other from the Options menu that appears. Maya automatically displays the Connection Editor, which allows you to connect one or more attributes from one node to attributes of another node. Our goal is to brighten any point on the body that is directly facing the camera, because those points will absorb the light more directly. Conversely, we want to darken those points that only partially face the camera or don't face the camera at all. As it just so happens, the attribute called Facing Ratio keeps track of the direction each point on the body is facing. Connect this to the V chord of the ramp by clicking one and then the other. Notice that a line is drawn from one tile to the other in the work area. You can reorganize the tiles quickly by selecting Body Matte and clicking the Input and Output Connections button. Maya rearranges the tiles so that they show all inputs to the left of the tile they are affecting. Now if you try rendering again, You can see that we get a much more natural light-to-dark progression. Now that we've set the base color, let's work on the specular color, which will determine the kind of shine we get. Create a new blend material and rename it to Body Specular Matte. Set the transparency to white. This will make the diffuse color invisible. We won't need the diffuse color because we already took care of that with our diffuse layer. Now set the specular color to the same color as your base. In order to drive the reflectivity of your specular layer, we're going to use another ramp. This time, set the ramp to go from black to white. You can click the small X button to remove the extra ramp handle. Don't use a straight black or a straight white, as few materials reflect light in such perfect tones. Also, be sure to set the interpolation to exponential down to get a more dramatic effect. Just like before, attach a sampler info node to the ramp. Connect the facing ratio attribute to the corresponding v-coord attribute. Now select Body Matte and middle mouse drag the Body Specular Matte layer next to the Body Diffuse layer. Make sure the specular layer is on the left side of the diffuse layer. Maya renders layers to the left over top of layers on the right. Now if you render the scene, you can see that your guitar has a sheen to it. To really give our guitar some visual punch, we're going to add some metallic flakes to it. This is similar to the kind of paint job you might see on custom show cars. Create another blend material and name it Body Flakes Matte. Set the transparency just less than halfway across the slider. We'll want the base color to show through this material. Also, set the specular color to black. Again, because we want the specular color to show through this material. Now, to create the texture for this material, we could either use a 2D bitmap image or a procedural shader. Let's use a procedural shader. A procedural shader will give us the ability to tweak specific attributes of the texture right in Maya until we get it looking exactly the way we want. Click the Map button next to the Color field and select 3D Textures in the Create Render Node window. To create our flakes, we're going to use a leather shader. Leather features two colors, one as a base color and the other in splotches on top of it. With some tweaking, we can turn the splotches into flakes that will sit on our base color. Upon creating the leather material, a 3D placement utility node appears in the scene. The leather also uses a default brown crease color. Change this to straight black. Now adjust the cell size and density to 0.5 and 0.4 respectively. This will adjust the size and number of flakes. We'll also want to increase the spottiness to 0.8, randomness to 1, and the threshold down to about 0.3 to keep the effect thorough but not too strong. Now we need to make the flakes themselves shiny. Create a Phong material for the cell color. Like Blin, Phong has a natural shininess to it. For the flakes to show up well, we need to change them to a color that really pops out of the red. In this case, let's choose a strong blue. Raise the ambient color a bit to make the blue stand out even further. Set the specular color to a light gray and reduce the cosine power to 5. The cosine power controls the tightness of the specular highlight. Notice that it gets bigger as we decrease the value. You can also increase the reflectivity to 1 to really make the flakes shine. Now select the body matte tile and middle drag the body flakes matte tile into the attribute editor. The flakes should sit on a layer between the specular and diffuse layers. Now you can render one more time. You now have a beautiful guitar body to go along with the rest of the components.